just going for it.
Professional football in America is a special game, a unique game, played nowhere else on earth. It is a rare game. The men who play it make it so.
Hey, baby, let's go out there like a bunch of crazy dogs and have some fun.
Coming now, buddy. We on our horse all day long. Let's just kick that butt all day long.
Pick it up. Don't stop. Pick it up. Let's go.
Get after the ball. Tattoo somebody.
Pro football is a mirror of early America, reflecting toughness, courage, and self-denial.
There he is! Whoa! Whoa! Good job! Good job!
That's what I make a play out there, buddy. Nice job.
Over Pirate 2, ready.
45 blast!
Yes, we're in play!
45 blast!
Keep on playing at this level now, huh? Keep it up, baby. Keep it up.
We're gonna be here all day, baby!
Is this fun or what?
The game is wide open, not confined. X's and O's on a blackboard are translated into imagination on the field. It can be one man rising above the obscurity of the grim, no-glory duty of special teams. It is a lineman clawing through the carnage at the scrimmage line and devouring the quarterback.
Brown right, Fox 2 run on set, ready?
The game is perpetual motion. A swirl of flying bodies in constant collision. A 2.5 hour carnival of color, sound, and action.
I got a little something for you.
There's glory in the legends of this hard muscle life, and there's poetry in each season made of sweat and strife.
Hey, hey, hey.
But now's the time to work and strain at a sport that tests the spirit and challenges the brain.
Come on, let's go.
Yeah, I'd like to have 75 degrees and sunny all the time too, but that's not football.
Do you fear the force of the wind, the slash of the rain?
We're gonna play it soon, lightning and rain.
Go face them and fight them. Be savage again. Seven trained men face to face on the field of play. Each man a specialist, but one man stands above the rest. He occupies the most critical position in the game. He is the quarterback. He plots, directs, and executes the on-field fortunes of his team. The quarterback lives in a world of pressure. How well he lives with it and reacts to it determines how good he is. He must have a cool disregard for danger and the courage to take punishment. The quarterback has two formidable allies. One is deception. By clever faking, he can confuse the defense and open a clear path for the play. His second ally is the forward pass. It's a long bomb. A screen pass over charging linemen. A bullet from the midst of a traffic jam. The pass in the hands of a pro quarterback is a bolt of lightning that can strike anywhere, anytime. Each quarterback in the NFL has his own particular style. There's Fran talking, who seeded the word scramble into the vocabulary of pro football. He may pass, run, or just drop back 20 or 30 yards before he makes up his mind. Sonny Jurgensen of the Washington Redskins, a whiplash passer whose rifle arm can put the ball anywhere on the field. Jurgensen is considered the finest Redskin quarterback since the Sime Barr era. John Unitas of the Baltimore Colts, a classic quarterback whose timing and control is cool, swift, and precise. Unitas, a fierce competitor with a flair for surprises. Bart Starr of the Green Bay Packers, a careable field general as well as an exponent of the calculated risk. He has guided his team to four world championships. Second only in importance to the mind and arm of the quarterback is the instinct and legs of the runner.
Richardson far side. And it's to Matty. Matty slips away. And Matty is out of bounds.
Give me 18 inches of daylight. That's all I need.
When Gale Sayers gets those 18 inches of daylight, the Chicago Bears usually win. When he doesn't, they don't. It's as simple as that. Gale Sayers, the halfback, the whirlwind runner that comes along once in a generation. He's an attack all by himself, a spinning, dancing dervish. The halfback, the runner with speed and breakaway ability. Every team in the NFL that boasts a balanced attack has a phantom flyer in its lineup. The power gear in the offensive machine is the fullback.
We tell our ball carrier to come across hard and fast till he gets the ball. Once he gets it, to come under control and button hook slightly. Key the block on the linebacker, key the block of the YN. If the YN has the linebacker taken out, he cuts inside. If the YN has the linebacker in, he comes all the way around. If you look at this play, what we're trying to get is a seal here and a seal here and try to run this play in the alley.
Jim Taylor, number 31, is a fullback, and this is the way of fullbacks. Power is the prime requisite. Quickness, an asset. The approach is not subtle. The yards he gains, the toughest. These are the runners, the racehorse halfbacks and locomotive fullbacks. Theirs is the speed and the fury, and to them must go the glory. This yard of space is called no man's land. Football games are won or lost by control of this narrow strip of land. The battle for it is a violent one. The hands of combat, the hands of pros. This is the part of the game rarely seen by the spectator. The shattering impact of a block. The mountainous size of an onrushing defender. The splintering force of a forearm shipper. 1 ton of muscle with a one-track mind. Down in the dirt, the lair of the lineman. This is where the game is played. The fringe of no man's land is patrolled by the linebackers. The search and destroy men of the defense. Sunday after Sunday, pro quarterbacks have learned that whatever play they call, a linebacker is likely to meet it head on. This is the face of the tiger. And And this, the action of a tiger. The linebackers provide the defense with enormous flexibility. They can charge through the line into the enemy backfield or slide laterally against plays to the outside. Roving far from the ruck of the scrimmage line is the pass receiver. His range carries him into heavy traffic. Or through the shifting dangers of a broken field. The pass catchers are pro football's men on the run, measuring their survival by the twist of a shoulder. A head fake. The burning speed that cuts them free. The philosophy of successful pass receiving is simple. Be alone when the ball arrives. But with a big tight end like John Mackey, number 88, it doesn't make any difference. Confident hands and disciplined patterns of Raymond Berry, number 82, have made him the most proficient pass catcher in history. The rapport that exists between a gifted passer and his favorite receiver is part instinct, part practice, and part luck. They have the hands, the moves, the grace, and a willing disregard for the consequence. Opposing the receiver is the defensive back. One man alone, facing another man alone. A man whose skill and wits he knows and fears but must cancel. His directive, stop the play. Guess and gamble, but don't fail. They're the last line of the defense. They pick up the pieces that the line and linebackers let through. For the defensive back, the glory is great. Or the disgrace, absolute. For others, there is anger, despair, exultation, moments of emotion that pierce the frenzy of play to reveal the man behind the uniform. So they call it pro football. They play it under the autumn moon, in the heat of a Texas afternoon. In the ice bucket chill of a Wisconsin winter. In the snow, fog, and wind. And thousands come to watch or sleep, to cheer or stand in silent adulation. And millions more sit at home before TV sets, pursuing the elusive magic of the Golden Game.
All right, 60 on 4 on the ISO. Very good. Ready, 1-1.
If I anticipate a dog and I go round right 83, that's Gary on the quick post.
Yeah.
Have him do an X V out, quick V out rather than the post.
Okay, Don.
There'll be still a dog pass, but tell him not to take a half hour to make the V out.
Don't take a half hour to make the V out either.
That's the official time.
Tell him about it. Tell him about the short yardage. He's going to go ahead and hit you.
If he stays out, go ahead and run a shoot. If he goes out, if I run up.
Do you think you would key it that fast?
Timmy, go in the next play and tell him to remember the stutter pass. Break right. Now, if Shinny comes, block him in. You got it?
Hey, listen. Tell Mel the next time on that Taylor now, he knows he's going for the turn in for the pick, so he wants to be ready to come across it.
Okay. Mel! Let's go. Right now.
Well, you see him released inside and Mike dropped off, so I figured we were playing it.
All right. I just told him about that late play. What do you call? Is it interference? What do you call? Hold him?
Whittingham grabbed his third.
Boy, that the gears in that guy's mind didn't mesh for a long time, I'll tell you that. Conviction in that! Pretty slow decision, Stan! Pretty slow decision! The ball hits the ground about that, he comes in, it's too late! Come on, turn the car! Down by 2 feet. 2 feet. He's got it easy.
I can't see.
Oh, the thing is way over here. He's got it by 2 feet.
Joe, look at that now. See how your eyes work?
A foot.
Said 2 feet.
All right, well, what's the difference between 8 inches and 2 feet?
8 inches.
A call. The ball is snapped and the play continues. A drama of man on man in a race against the clock. It's precision, persistence, power. The unleashed speed of the kickoff, the whistling feet of a great runner, the reckless fury of a goal line stand, the crowning glory of a winning touchdown, the swelling roar of the crowd. It's called pro football.